Okay, we're back. Sorry about that. So, what was I saying? Wildstar, yes. So, one of my biggest problems, like I said, is the disconnect from the player and the character. Now, there's some people in the chat saying that the way a story is delivered is very important. And that's true. There is a way a story should be delivered. If it's delivered out of order or wrong, the story will be broken. But that's why the. That's why one of the issues I run into is if you're going to have this carefully crafted story that must be delivered in a very specific way, then do that, but at the same time, give the player options and don't put them on this rail that they must follow without any diverging path off of said quest line. You accept the quest, there's only one way to complete it, and that is to collect 10 bear asses. And once you have said 10 bear asses, quest complete, go back and turn it in. Even in the Guild Wars 2 style, where you don't get the quest from a quest giver, but you still have the quest because you're in that particular area, there's only one way to do the quest, and that is to collect the 10 bear asses. There is no other way around it. If you want to do this quest, you must do the way it's designed in that mechanic. And that takes choice away from the player. So then you're not so much playing a role, you're playing an actor. An actor in a movie has a script, and that script must be followed. Okay? Even if the director of a movie says, "Listen, you can ad lib a little bit off of this, but this is primarily what your character is going to do, and you die in this scene. In this scene, you die." The actor can't go, "Well, wait a minute, I think my character should live." No, you die. This is just there's a script, and this is the part of the movie where you die. In MMORPGs, as of late, your character will always succeed in a very specific way. There's a script you must follow. You're playing an actor. You're an actor. And the story has already been predetermined. That's the thing. The conclusion to said story is a foregone conclusion. You cannot change this. It will not be altered or changed in any way by you or anyone else. You will go collect 10 bear asses, and the guy after you will also collect 10 bear asses, and the guy after him will also collect 10 bear asses. You must do this. You don't have to take the quest, but if you do take the quest, that's your only option. Take it and don't get the experience, or take it and do it in this very specific way. That is not playing the role of a character in an RPG. That is the act of playing a role as an actor in a movie script or a story script. You are a play actor. You are following the script as been predetermined by the writer. You are nothing more than a pawn to be used in the way the storyteller wants you to be played as. So you'd say, "Well, great. I get to play as an important character." But your destiny as that character, the end of that journey, has already been decided for you. There is no way to alter the ending. You just don't know what the ending is. And if I want to watch a movie, I'll watch a movie. Because you know what? When you take a movie and you put it in a DVD or a Blu-ray player and you watch a movie, the ending has already been figured out. Okay? Objectively speaking, there is an end, and that end will always be the same. No matter how many times you watch Ghostbusters, the good guys win in the end. Sorry to spoil it for you. The movie's only been out for 20 some odd years. So if you haven't seen Ghostbusters by now, spoiler alert, the good guys win. But no matter how many times you watch Ghostbusters, Egon proposes crossing the streams. Ray agrees, goes, "Cross the streams." And that's how they beat Gozer. And every single time you watch Ghostbusters, guess what? Egon proposes that they cross the streams. Ray goes, "Cross the streams." And they defeat Gozer. Every time. So the first time you watch a movie, the last time you watch a movie, it doesn't matter. The end will always be the same. It won't magically change on the DVD or Blu-ray. It will always be what it has been predetermined to be. MMORPGs today have the same problem. The end will always be this. It will never change. It will never evolve. It will never be altered by your actions or anyone else's. The actions you take have zero impact on whether or not good guy wins or good guy loses. Even if you wipe in a raid, because when you come back, no negative penalty. There's no downside to wiping other than losing some time and some gold or money or whatever monetary system they use in that game. And it's just a matter of attrition. Eventually, you bang your head against it long enough, the bad guy loses. The bad guy never wins or loses depending on your actions. Even if he wins the fight, you just come back and try again and try again and try again. It's a foregone conclusion that the good guys will win. The bad guys will lose. You will collect those 10 bear asses. You will go collect those 10 bear asses if you want to complete that quest. And you're going to want to complete that quest because you get experience and loot out of it. You can opt not to do the quest, but you know what? If you decide later to go take that quest again, guess what? You have to still go collect 10 bear asses. And that's the problem. I've played this game already. And if I really want to play a game like WildStar, I'll go play World of Warcraft because I know that game better. So why would I go out of my way to play a game with a whole new storyline that I know nothing about, with a whole new system that I have to relearn from the beginning, when in reality, the play style of the game is no different than the game I played for 7 or 8 years? Adamantly. That's the problem. Not to mention the fact that the way that WildStar delivers the story, the way they deliver the story, makes me not care at all. I have really tried. Even with the open beta, I logged in and I was like, you know what? Maybe I was just being pessimistic. Maybe I was just being too cynical. Maybe I was just being way, way too harsh on the game. Let me try it again from as an objective point of view as possible. Let me push out all my preconceptions about this game and all my misconceptions about this game and go into it with a fresh mind and just really just, you know what, forget all that nonsense. Just play the game. Just play the game. And you know what? I got to about level 12 or 13 and I was like, I can't do this anymore. I can't do this anymore because I'm doing the same thing over and over and over and over and over again. And that is get quest. Go do quest, regardless of what menial thing it is, that has no impact on my character or the story. It's just to progress to the next quest hub. It is an act in futility to keep going until you get that, whoa, one level higher. And then, ooh, I'm one level higher again. And ooh, I'm one level higher again. Meanwhile, these levels mean nothing because all they really mean, the only goal of leveling is to get to the next one. And then the only reason to get to that one is to get to the next one. And then ultimately, the final goal is to get to the maximum level. That is your goal. From level 1 till 50, the only goal you really have is to get to 50 as quickly as possible. Why? Because that's when the real game starts. And then, once you're level 50 in the case of WildStar, or level 90 in the case of World of Warcraft, it's bang your head against this raid over and over again until they release a new one. And then you bang your head against that raid over and over again until they release the new one. There's no rhyme or reason to do these things. There is no reason. There's no purpose behind it other than attrition. Well, it's fun to raid with my friends. Yeah, fine. Everything's fun with your friends. Watching paint dry is fun with your friends. Get a case of beer, paint the wall, sit around and watch it dry, and you'll have a blast. All right? Because it's not what you're doing that's fun. It's who you're doing it with that's fun. So if you end up with this essentially a revolving door of content. You're just banging your head against this thing until the next thing comes out. And that one, you do that one. And then you're like, whoa, we beat the boss. And you're like, yay, well, new boss. And you're like, well, I guess this boss really wasn't that important. That's the real boss now. Okay, so you go do that guy. And you're like, oh, we killed him. And you're like, aha, you killed the Lich King. But now it's Deathwing. You're like, oh, all this time we thought Lich King, but now it's Deathwing. Let's go kill Deathwing. And you run the whole gamut. And then finally Deathwing's released. And you kill Deathwing. You're like, oh, we killed Deathwing. It's, aha, you thought Deathwing. Now it's the Shaw of Anger or whatever the fuck it was. I really lost track after Cataclysm. I really didn't follow it anymore. So if Endgame is the real game, and I'll say this again, if Endgame is when the real game starts, then why bother having a leveling process in the first place? Why even bother with it? There's no point to it then. If there is a point to it, then you need to make sure your leveling process is enjoyable and has a purpose other than training them to raid. That's not a good reason to have a leveling curve, okay? If the only reason to... It's a circular argument, by the way. If the only reason to level is to learn how to raid, and the only reason to raid is so that you can get better gear to raid some more, then the whole game is about raiding. Right? Let's follow this logic for a second. You start a level 1 character. Your goal at level 1 is to get to 50 in Wildstar, right? That's max level. That's your goal. 1 to 50. That's your goal. Once you get to 50, you have one of two options. You can do both at the same time, but primarily you have one of two ways you can go. PvE or PvP, right? Okay. Now, the whole point in leveling at that point, the whole point of leveling is to get to 50. That's it. And the only reason to do that is to go either to PvP or to PvE land. That's it. And then once you're in PvE land, the whole point of being there at all is just to keep going in circles, getting better gear, getting better monsters, going better gear, going better monsters, going... It's just a big circular clusterfuck of shit. I get better gear so I can go do better raids, but I do the better raids so I can get better gear. But I didn't get the better gear so I can go do better raids, but then I get better raids so I can do better gear. And I get better gear, better raids, better raids. What the fuck's the point? Well, oh wait, of course not. What about the PvP? Oh, there's a whole worthwhile fucking endeavor. I'm going to go and queue up for battlegrounds, or I'm going to go do arenas, or whatever the fucking system they're going to have. I'm going to do PvP. Okay, so congratulations. You just went in and you just killed 5 people with your epic skills. What did you get to gain out of that? Well, I got gear. Cool. You got gear. What does that gear help you do? Well, it helps me kill people better. So really, you've accomplished absolutely nothing. You've got nothing out of this. No, I got gear. No, you didn't. You got gear, but the gear is meaningless because the whole point you got the gear is so you could do more PvP. And then you'll do more PvP to get more gear. It's the same argument. Whether you're doing more PvP to get more gear to do more PvP, or you're doing more PvE to get more gear to do more PvE, it's the same shit. You're just doing X to get Y to go back to do more X to do more Y. It's a fucking circle. And in the middle of it, the fucking developers are going, ha 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 ha, yes, keep playing. Aren't you having fun? If I want to do PvP, you know what I'll do? I'll go play League of Legends because at least, I don't have to delude myself into what it really is. I play a character that, whatever, who cares about the lore? They have it, but who cares? Malzahar, okay, I like Malzahar. He's my guy. I roll up Malzahar and I go into Summoner's Rift and I pwn noobs for about 30 minutes and then I'm done. You know, and that was my fun. That's it. You don't need to build a whole MMO around it. You don't need to have this elaborate system of leveling and gear level and all this shit. Just fucking load up League of Legends, load up Call of Duty, Battlefield, like first-person shooters, or MOBAs, or RTSs. Go play StarCraft 2. I hate StarCraft 2, but hey, you like StarCraft 2? Go play it. There's Smite. There's tons of games that focus heavily on PvP if that's what you want. That's what you want? Go play them. There's tons of them, and most of them are free. Smite's free. League of Legends is free. Team Fortress 2 is free. Hey, it's PvP. I don't understand. There's absolutely no point in doing this circular nonsense to get gear to do more PvP, to go back to do more gear. It's fucking pointless. You're defining what you're doing by what you get to, so you can redefine what you're doing. It doesn't mean anything. It doesn't mean a goddamn thing. And that's why I quit World of Warcraft. That's specifically why I quit World of Warcraft, was because I was raiding to get better gear. And the only reason why I was getting the better gear was so that when the next tier of raiding came out, I could do that raiding. And it's like, well, then why am I here? You go into the raid, you're like, we're here. And people will say, well, wait a minute, Corpse Lot. That's not the only reason why people do raiding. They're not there just for the gear. They're there for the experience of the raid. Really? Really? If that's true, then why do you run it multiple times? And I don't mean, oh, you wiped on the boss, you have to go back and try again. I mean, you've cleared the fucking dungeon. You've cleared it. It's over. It's over. You've killed every boss in that dungeon, in that raid. You've killed them all. But you'll go back and do it again. Okay, maybe it's fun the second time around. New people. Eh, right. And then they'll go a third time, and a fourth time, and a fifth time, and a sixth time, and a seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth. They'll keep going back and back. It's a weekly thing. Siege of Orgrimmar. How many times have guilds killed Garrosh? How many times? How many times have raids gone into the Siege of Orgrimmar raid to kill off Garrosh? How many? What, they want it for the experience? No, they're there for the loot. They're there for the gear. That's why they go in there. That's why they go in there 6, 7, 8 times. There's some guilds who only do it once. Because they just don't, they're lucky they got that far. Fine. But most of the guilds who are heavy raiding guilds do not do raids once or twice after they've killed the boss. They keep going because they need the gear. They need the gear. Why do they need the gear? Because when the next raid is released, they're going to have to go do that one, and they need the gear from the raid they're in to do it. So the bullshit argument of, well, we go in for the first time because we want to experience it. Okay, well, you've experienced it. You've killed everything. Well, that was, well, now we need the gear. Oh, okay. So here comes a circular thing. And PvP's the same way. PvP's the same way. We're the best, arena team in the world. Congratulations. Are you done PvPing now? No, we're going to do it again. But we got to get more gear so we can do it again. And get more gear so we can do it again. What? Why? Dude, just play a PvP game. Play a game that's what it's about. I mean, you can't. What? What are you doing? It's a lot of the same shit. And WildStar is no different. And hey, look, if you like that kind of gameplay, if that's your thing, then fucking great. Have fun. Guild Wars 2, WildStar, fucking whatever, World of Warcraft, have a blast. If that's your thing, go. But you're not going to convince me. You will never, you can try and you will fail to convince me that circular bullshit that they run you through is good or fun. It's not fun. I got, back in World of Warcraft days, when they went from vanilla to Burning Crusade, I was pissed. I loved Burning Crusade, don't get me wrong, but I was really pissed how they neutered the gear I was wearing. I had all this really great gear on my character, and then Burning Crusade came out, and they reset the gear score. They reset the gear, quest greens from Burning Crusade were replacing epic, raid gear I had on my character. The first quests you do were better than the shit I already had on. I was like, well, that's stupid, and I was kind of annoyed by that. All right, fine. And then they did it again in Wrath. And I'm like, why'd you do it again? And now they did it again in Cataclysm. Then they did it again in Pandaria. I'm like, fuck you. So what you're telling me is I do all these raids to get all this, to get the best gear in the game. And then like 6 months later, All of that gear I earned, all of that stuff that I have is made completely irrelevant and worthless because the first quest I do in the new zone will be a green quest item will absolutely replace what I was already wearing. That's absolutely stupid. Then what's the point of even raiding? More than once. More than one time. What's the point? Well, to get better gear. Why? When the next expansion comes out, it's just going to be replaced. Who cares? Who cares? That's the problem. I play WildStar and I'm like, why am I playing this? I could just be playing World of Warcraft. I know that game better. I know that game better. Why play this when I can play that? I don't want to play that. That's why I left World of Warcraft to begin with. Guyman999 says, you can make the same argument for any game that a person attempts to play twice. No. Some games have multiple ways to play through it. Okay? For example, there are some games that have a lot of replayability. You could try the game. For example, I'll take Skyrim as an example. Skyrim is a very short game. And you know, respectively, it's a relatively short RPG. But you could play the game as a melee fighter. Next time you play through, you might do it as an assassin, stealthy, roguey type person. Next time you play through, you might play it as a spellcaster and see if you can do it that way. There's multiple ways to play that game and get through it. And it warrants multiple playthroughs. Games like, say, you know, Metal Gear Revengeance. Not really. You could make the argument that you could play through it a second time using, I don't know, a different weapon. Most of the time, it's a one playthrough type game. You might go back to it a year later just because you have this urge to slash things with the mechanics. But really, you're not playing Metal Gear over and over and over and over and over again. And just like Skyrim, some people play it a lot, but you're really not going to play it and then reload and like start from scratch and play it all over again and go. Unless you're trying something completely different, those games allow you to try something completely different. In MMORPGs, if you're a spell slinger, if you're a druid, if you're an esper, or if you're a mage, it doesn't matter. Sure, you can say, well, I'm going to go beat the boss as a fire mage, and I'm going to go back and beat the boss as a frost mage, and the guild will be like, no, we want you as arcane, because arcane can go the fuck home. And even if you did change what spec you're doing, it's not exactly like, wow, that was a whole different experience, because when I was in there as arcane, that was super easy, but in there as fire, holy shit, it was like a whole new experience. No, it wasn't. It was the same shit. It was just different colored shit flying out of your character. It was either purple and white shit flying out of your character, or it was red and orange shit flying out of your character. At the end of the day, you're still doing damage, and it's still from a ranged. You're just hitting different buttons in a different order, but really, it's the same shit. So, but playing as a mage as opposed to a warrior. Yeah, you could play as a warrior or you could play as a mage, but at the end of the day, what you're doing doesn't change much. And I've said this before. In MMORPGs, there's three classes. World of Warcraft specifically has three classes. You have the tank class, you have the healer class, and you have the DPS class. What shape, size, and color of their effects happen to be is completely irrelevant. They've made it completely irrelevant. Your DPS class, I don't care if you're a hunter, I don't care if you're a rogue, I don't care if you're a mage, I don't care if you're a warlock, I don't care if you're a fucking shadow priest. It doesn't matter. You're a DPS, you are the DPS class. Because anything else you have to offer is meaningless. The only thing that matters is how much damage you can do as fast as possible. That's all that matters. The tank class, whether you're a giant bear, or a warrior, or a paladin, or a death knight, it doesn't matter. Or the monk, I guess the monk can tank now. I guess, maybe. I don't even know. I really know nothing about Pandaria. You're know what you're doing. You're hitting whatever class, you know, whatever buttons you need to hit to make sure that target A is still looking at you. So you have three classes. Now, there's nothing wrong with having classes that fill the DPS role and classes that fill the tank role and classes that fill the healer role, as long as those classes do more than just damage. It used to be in World of Warcraft, bringing any old DPS to a fight wasn't enough. You had to have the right kind of DPS. You might have needed a hunter or two, or you might need a paladin or two, or a priest or two, or a mage with polymorph, or a warlock with its crowd control abilities. You might have needed a hunter to have a pet tank, something off tanking this, and there was different compositions that you could do with that DPS in order to make the fights, you know, a lot easier to do, and there was strategy involved. That went away. You could probably find examples where, well, I'm actually Corpse Lot, if you have three mages in this fight. Yeah. It's so meaningless now. It is so subdued. It doesn't matter anymore. Wildstar, are you seriously going to tell me DPS classes bring enough utility to the fight that the fact that they do damage isn't enough? Really? I'll wait to see that. But back to my original point. If you kill a boss in World of Warcraft, the only reason to go back and do it again, is to get gear. The experience does not change. It does not become all that much more epic and awesome because you went with a different class. It doesn't. Okay? It does not become more epic and awesome because the first time you killed him, you were a mage, but now you're a death knight. It's a whole new experience. No, it's not. It's the same stupid shit. You've done it once, and now it's routine. There was an old joke that my old guild used to do. And we used to say, every time we killed a boss for the first time, we'd kill a boss for the first time. Farm status. We knew he wasn't really on farm status, but that was the joke. He's now on farm status. We're going to come back every week now and kill this boss to get epic loot. And back then, we were like, yeah. And then, like, years later, we were like, why are we doing this again? This is, like, the third time we've killed this guy. Does anybody really want anything off this guy? No, not really. Well, I could use the helm. Really, could you? It's a slight upgrade than what I got. Well, it's just Pokemon syndrome. Got to catch them all, right? Got to get all the set pieces. Got to get all the thingies. It's meaningless. It has no. It's such a shallow experience. It's such a meaningless endeavor. Going through those dungeons and killing bosses and doing all that happy horseshit is so meaningless. And the reason why it's meaningless is because it has no bearing on your character or your character's involvement with the story. None. In fact, even in World of Warcraft, when you kill the Lich King back in Wrath, when you've killed the Lich King, your character is so uninvolved, they don't even mention him when they... It's Bolvar and fucking what's-his-nuts. They're, oh, he's dead now. Here, you're the new Lich King. And you're like, where's my guy? I just fucking... Me and, like, 19 other buddies or whatever, we just... You know, or whatever, how many people were there. 24 other buddies, whatever. We just slaughtered this motherfucker, you know, and we're not even mentioned in the fucking credits. Thank God those adventurers showed up when they did. Oh, wow. Thanks for the side. Like, hey. It's so meaningless. Anyway, I'm going to take a quick break once again, folks. I'm going to go stretch the legs, and I'll be right back.